Hello again, Brick Warrior fans. Well, we made it. Video numero dos. Yeah. Which means I didn't get fired. Woo. Not that there was a real possibility, but in the last video when talking about Ryan, one of my bosses, I did kind of say that at one point I thought he was a butthead. I kind of insulted his work ethic, and I definitely insulted his fashion sense, but phew, I'm still here. So I thought I'd start this video off on a positive note and say that of all my bosses here at BrickWarriors, Ryan is my favorite. After Amanda, of course. I mean, she's like my best friend, so. But hey, second place, not bad. So the feedback from the first video was very nice. I think we're up to 6 likes on YouTube. What? And even better, 0 dislikes. That's the dream. I mean, come on. So because of the nice response from the first video, this kind of puts a lot of pressure on video number 2. But not to worry, I've had some amazing brainstorming sessions. This is crap! Amazing might not be the right word. One thing I did think of, since this is behind the BrickWarriors mask, was to take you on a tour of our lovely office. I should say that we've been here for a little over 2 months now. It's not that big, it's not really that decorated, and it's not really that interesting, actually. With that said, though, let's get started. All right, so this is my desk, which is actually just a table. And, oh look, there are my real shoes, and these are my work shoes. Ooh, super professional. Okay, so printer, desk slash table. As you can see, there's no orders to be done right now, so I'm not procrastinating. And now to the aisle of storage bins filled with BrickWarrior pieces. Ooh, ah. So you might wonder how we have everything organized. Well, it goes in order of the molds the pieces were made in, the mold being what gives this piece its shape and makes it so that all of the Minotaur axes look exactly alike. So these were the pieces from the first few molds ever made at BrickWarriors way back in 2011. Fascinating stuff. So then it goes in order of how they came out with everything. Let's see, we have some dervish blades, goblin helmets. You might notice that some of the bins are empty, and that's because we run out of that color or that piece. And then some of the bins are empty because I am too lazy to refill them. Okay, so here we go, still in order. Got some dragon wings, dragon tails, ogre armor, my favorite. And keeps going, and it comes around over this side. We have some lots of plumes in this area. Android armor, galaxy enforcer. And it comes around here. Lots of cool stuff. We have our packs down here. There's some mystery packs, the warrior packs. Keeps going. Anvils, tridents. And then it comes around on this side, but oops, I can't show you this side because some of the pieces we don't have out yet. But ones I can show you are City Watch helmet, very popular right now. Gladius, and one of my favorites, and I'm being completely sarcastic, is the Cornu. Look at all this fun stuff I get to deal with. And then here at the end, we have some pieces in colors that we are going to no longer be selling. Once we're done, we're done. So we have silver Russian assault rifles. Get them while they last. And as you can see, the red sombreros are very popular. That is sarcasm because obviously we have a lot. Okay, that's the aisle of storage bins. Now let's play a fun game called Can Cori guess what the piece is by not looking at it? It's a fun new game. Try playing it at home. That's impossible because you're not me. Okay, don't look. That bin is empty. Okay, this is, oh, these are antlers. Aha. Let's do another one. I was looking. I'll admit to that. I was looking. Okay. Stop looking. This is Skull Crusher. Oh, yeah. And there you go. Okay, next on our tour, I will take you over to this side of the office. Here we have some warrior packs. These are the ones that we sell in toy stores, mostly Five Below, but some other places as well. And over here, we have the sealer, which is what we use to close up the packs. Press down on this pedal, and it seals it. And yeah, here's a pack that needs sealing. So let's see this baby in action, huh? And all sealed, ready to go. Awesome. Okay, and from here we can take you to our little camera setup. As you can tell, really professional. I mean, all the best people use boxes as their like table. And we have lighting right here. And yeah, this cowboy guy. So this is where we would take pictures of the pieces that we can put online. So we can have a nice clean white background. And then also I'll be making some videos to show how you can hold the pieces and just give you a better look so you can tell if you really want to buy that piece or not. This is actually exactly how they filmed the Lego movie. Fun fact. Okay, so from there we have random stuff in the corner, and then we have the storage room. Bags and bags and bags of Brick Warrior pieces. Amazing stuff. And this again goes in the order of the molds, so this is all the older stuff, all the way up to the newer stuff. And hey, look, random boxes. Amazing. So let's see, here we have a bag full of pearl gold brute armor. That should be 100 pieces. Amazing stuff. So yeah, that's pretty much everything. We only have one window in here, but fortunately it's a nice big one. And look, we even have a little Brick Warrior sign up that faces to the outside and scares all the other office people. So that was your tour of Brick Warrior's offices. Wasn't that as boring as I thought it would be?
Okay, so that's gonna be pretty much it for this video. I know you guys saw a lot today, so I'm gonna give you some time to process all of that. A few notes though. Number one, I've decided to start a video series within this video series where I will be taking Lego minifigures with Brick Warriors accessories on them and reenacting a scene from a movie or a TV show or whatever, and I'm gonna call it Brick Warriors Wood. It's like Hollywood, but Brick Warriors. So yeah, if you have any suggestions for that, let me know. And secondly, we will be releasing new stuff this month. And if we don't, then Amanda's a liar, and it's not my fault. Finally, I want to let you know that we will be at 3 LEGO conventions coming up. First one, April 26th and 27th, we will be at Philly Brickfest. And that is in Oaks, Pennsylvania, because Oaks Brickfest just doesn't sound as cool. The next weekend we will be at Scouting for Bricks in Leesburg, Virginia. That's May 3rd and May 4th, and that features yours truly, so definitely check that one out. And finally, we will be at Brick Fair New England, May 10th and May 11th, which is in Manchester, New Hampshire. I will be leaving all the information for these conventions in the summary below, so check them out. Yeah, that's it. So thanks for watching, and as always, send in any suggestions, comments, questions that you have, and we'll see if I get to answer them. All right, see you later. Cori, the GM, signing off. Juggling. I can show off my sick juggling skills. Yes. And, I can use BrickWarriors juggling pins. Oh my gosh, yes.
Wait, I can't juggle.
Check out BrickWarriors.com.